It's a watershed day in the world for sure. Congratulations, everybody, because you made it to February 12th, 2014. Amazing, amazing, amazing what's going on. And I will explain exactly the situation. As I was sitting on the night of the 11th, the whole situation that's going on in the world, the entire thing became very crystal clear. The whole thing. Now you may say, yeah, that's great. Okay, now we're going to find out, you know, what's going to happen. Not exactly. Because really, if I told you exactly what's going to happen, you would be so infuriated that you would not be able to do what you need to do, which is what? Right spiritual practice. This information, you only become aware of it when your own right spiritual practice is strong enough to be sustained. And I reached that yesterday on the 10th. Well, it was 2 days ago now because this is the 12th, but on Sunday the 10th, I reached... for me, I understand right spiritual practice enough to share with other people. And so I finished that. And amazingly, all my external life, everything suddenly got all finished and put in place in one day on Monday. And it's like everything is completely ready now. Completely ready. It's amazing. Absolutely amazing. The inside, the outside, the work, everything has come to like a zero point suddenly. Just like clockwork. And then tonight, the night of the 11th, the whole picture of what's going to happen was laid bare for me. So, what I'm saying is the following. When the events take place that are going to take place in this world, you have a choice. And the choice that I'm advocating is that you go in the direction that is indicated to you by what I would call the saints of God, the grace of God. The saints of God are going to somehow show up, guide us in our life. And we have the option of actually sidestepping the troubles of this world. And I'll tell you why this is such a big deal. And it seems simple enough for everybody, but here's the problem. And this is the problem I've been working on for so many years. It's very simple to sidestep the problems that are coming. But people have been so intimidated and frightened away from right spiritual practice that they don't feel that they can do it. It's so simple, but they don't believe they can do it. As I've said before, it starts with honesty with God and just say, God, I have a continuity problem, meaning, God, I've been dreaming for so long of trying to leave reality, you know, trying to do something with this not right, and I've forgotten. To say, God, I've forgotten what my home is like. I forgot what my home is like. Will you please remind me? That's it. That's right spiritual practice. That begins the right spiritual practice. From that point on, you are in. You've got it made. You're saved. God, I forgot what my home was like. I need to be reminded. Would you please remind me? That's it. That's all that has to be done. As a start. You're in. You're in the club. Just like that. This flower just a couple days ago was just a little bud, and then I said, wow, what's going on? And suddenly, kaboom, it just bloomed just like that. So we could bloom very quickly into right spiritual practice. Very simple. So what I'm here for is to point out how easy it is, how simple it is. The problem is people are super intimidated. They say, I can't go with the saints of God. Who am I? I don't know how to pray. I don't know how to right spiritual practice. And they say, well, it's easy. They say, well, I might be able to do it once, but I can't do it every day. That's impossible. Impossible. For many people, they think it's impossible. Couldn't be farther from the truth. Now, for me, I've been doing right spiritual practice since 1978, never missed a day, and doing immense amount of spiritual practice in that time, absolutely immense. So I know, of course it's possible. Of course it's possible. But we don't need to do that. I was fast tracked. But all we have to do is it starts to say, God, I can't remember what my home was like. I've forgotten. I've forgotten, which of course means that we were falling into a dream, into a coma. How else could we forget what our home is like unless we've been in a coma of forgetfulness? So you're admitting to God, hey, I fell into a coma of forgetfulness. That's a first step. And then you listen to God, you listen to the grace of God, voice of reason within, and gradually it's explained to you, you know, what you did, what you tried to do, what happened, and you know, the projection that you used, and you can work through the guilt, and you get the forgiveness, and all this stuff comes to you. Just simply starting out and say, you know, I've forgotten what I want to go home. I've forgotten. What is home like? Can you please remind me before I go home so when I arrive, I'll know what it's like. It's like the prodigal son story. It's exactly just like that, you know. So everybody can start out on the whole thing coming up in the world is those who decide that they can start right spiritual practice and those who say, think that they cannot. Those who can think they cannot are going to end up under the boot, you know, of what's going to come in the world for sure. And that's going to be very nasty. I don't advise that under any circumstances. So I want everybody to just start right spiritual practice. Say, God, I can't remember what reality's like. I've forgotten. Can you please remind me? Basically saying, God, I have a continuity problem. That's all. I don't have a world problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a global problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a crisis problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a universal problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem I have. I can't remember what reality is like. I've forgotten. That's it. That's the entire thing right there. I've forgotten. Will you please remind me? And so this is the difference between sidestepping the problems to come and not sidestepping them. That's it. It's the entire thing. It pivots on just that. Just that. Just an honesty. Just say, I forgot, that's all. Just say that. God, I've forgotten what my home is like. I've forgotten what reality's like. I just can't remember. I can't seem to remember. Who can here? Almost nobody here can remember. Almost everybody's in an extremely deep coma of forgetfulness. But the first step of gradually awakening is to say, hey, I can't remember reality. So I need help. I need to be reminded of reality. That's all. It's still there. Reality is still real. It's absolutely omnipresence. Is still omnipresent, but we have forgotten omnipresence. The omnipresence of God is God, and we've forgotten that. And we're looking for it in things and places and people. You know, deep in forgetfulness. I was at an airport yesterday, SFO, and spent like about over 2 hours there, just waiting. And I was watching the human zoo there and everything, and I was able to do right spiritual practice within all the hubbub and intensity and everything of the airport. I was able to see everything is optimally resolved right in this moment. This person, this human body is optimally resolved at this very moment. As it is, this human body is optimally resolved. I mean, everything is optimally resolved into spaciousness, into omnipresence. As it is, this moment, everything is optimally resolved into omnipresence, always, right? Right this, right now, right here, this place, this location, right now. So I was able to do that. That was a task. It's a very difficult place to do right spiritual practice, actually. So much stuff going on, right? At an airport. But I was able to do it, so I could do it anywhere, actually. So as we go forward, the month, starting from the 13th of February to the 13th of March, that is when it's a very crucial time. Well, I went to the place I saw in my dream that showed me when the troubles were going to happen. Exact spot, and the fruit trees are not yet in bloom, actually. There's a lot of trees in bloom here. As you can see, there's flowers in bloom. There's just a ton of bloom. But that particular spot where the fruit trees were, they're not in bloom yet. But I saw buds, you know, so they're going to break out and bloom over the next month for sure. So what I've experienced is that we get the clarity by the 12th. We have to have right spiritual practice, be clear about it, be clear about the importance of it. And the whole thing was laid bare. And now this next month is moving time. You know, there's going to be great, great help begin to unfold in this next month. And then I anticipate the troubles may arrive in about a month's time or so. But certainly within this next month, maybe towards the end of that month or just after this next month, is likely the troubles are going to arise. So we have a little grace period here, actually. I was given this date. It said, get ready by that date. Well, I'm ready. But there's still some, you know, there's still a situation of how do we optimize the readiness at this point. I think a lot of people kind of know what's going to happen, actually. That, you know, they sort of put two and two together, and it is worse than we think, really. And it's very optimally bad is what's going to happen here. But we've been warned about it for sure. We've been warned about it, what's going to happen here. And in hindsight, we'll say, of course, it was obvious all along what's going on. Actually, they tipped their hand all along. But we just can't bring ourselves to believe something like this could happen here. We just can't believe it. Because a lot of people don't really understand the role extraterrestrials play on this planet. They really don't. They either don't believe in them or think they're kooks if they believe it, or they think, well, I just don't want to think about it. Extraterrestrials play an enormous role on this planet. In fact, a pivotal, crucial role at this time. And they are the ones pulling the strings, actually, behind the scenes. And they have their agenda for sure. And they have ways of reaching their agenda for sure. And if you think that they play by our rules, then you're in for a very rude awakening. That is for sure. They have their own rules. And the rules that we have, humans have here on this planet, mutual regard, mutual respect, fair play, all this stuff that we have, they don't care about that in the slightest bit. Not in the slightest bit do they care about that stuff. So that's why we're in for a rude awakening. And they're going to do things their way. Of course, when it comes to right spiritual practice, we'll do things our way. You see, that's the trump card. They have an ace up their sleeve for sure. For sure, they have an ace up their sleeve. And you can figure it out. But we have a trump card that trumps every ace up any sleeve, which is right spiritual practice, which is to say, God, I can't remember what reality is like, could you please remind me? That's all you need to do. That's the trump card. It's called the continuity issue, the continuity card. Play the continuity card. That trumps everything. Literally, it's literally the ticket to sidestep the nastiness in this world. Literally. Continuity card. If you've got that, you're in. You know, you are going to be saved from the troubles. You just say, God, I can't remember what reality's like. Would you please help me remember? So, as far as sidestepping the trouble to come, finding yourself in a very better place, much better place, much better situation. Like, wow, this is great. That's part of remembering. What our home is really like, what reality is really like. That's part of it. That's part of waking up from the coma. That's part of dealing with the continuity issue. It's part of it. It's the medicine you got to take. It's the medicine of remembrance. And so you just have to accept it and say, well, oh, this is now I chose my path, and this is what I come across on my path, is I have to adjust to better conditions, really, really super better conditions, much more beautiful conditions, much more fresh conditions, much safer conditions. You have to adapt to that. It is a process of adapting. There's no question about it. I've been put through this on a minor scale, and you find yourself like maybe on the best spot on the planet Earth. I just wanted to stay there and didn't want to move. I said, well, I just don't want to move. I just want to just soak this up. Just soak it up, soak it up. Wow. Beautiful. So still, so peaceful, so beautiful. You say, oh, this, I love this. I love this. I love this. I don't want to ever leave this. that's stressful. It's an adaptation. We're having to adapt to better circumstances. So, you know, it's a challenge. For sure it's a challenge. Conversely, those who think they cannot do right spiritual practice, cannot be honest with God, their path is in a different direction, and they will come across situations on that path that turn out to be huge challenges for them. You don't want those challenges, I can tell you. You know, how do I process this, you know, horribleness? You know, how do I process this extreme, vicious, violent, you know, wretchedness? How do I process that? How do I adapt to that? So they'll have adaptation challenges too, but in totally different ways. So, you know, both paths have adaptation challenges for sure, but the path of the remembrance has the adaptation challenge is for that which is so sublime, more and more sublime, very beautiful, which is why I tried to include in videos, previous ones, so much beautiful artwork like Nicholas Roerich, pictures of great saints of God, pictures of beautiful locations, things that are really sublimely beautiful as much as possible. So you can get the idea that this is something you will need to adapt to, actually. And it's very possible, absolutely. I feel comfortable in very beautiful surroundings now. Like I feel I belong there, you know, because I know I can do right spiritual practice, which means you belong there. Because you're honest, say, God, I need help, and here's the help. Just like that, very simple. So, this should at least give you something to think about. I don't know what I'm going to do tomorrow, I really don't. The next day. Things are winding down. They're just like, wow. Just coming to a sudden end. So many things are just coming to a nice, gentle, you know, soft landing. And there's really not much else to do in a lot of different ways. So something else is bound to come up. So once again, the issue of the saints of God, who are certainly going to help us, they certainly know what's going on. They know ahead of time what's going on. Many, many, many do know what's going on, actually. I've pretty much spelled it out in previous videos in various places, but right now there's no reason to be super direct about it because, again, it would infuriate people too much. It would change the mood of those I'm trying to help. It would change their mood too much. The focus has to be on right spiritual practice now, most definitely. You can't sink into a funk or depression right now. So if it was told you exactly what's going to happen, you'd get depressed for sure, because you'd be upset. You'd be upset for sure. You'd be upset. So that's counterproductive. Right now you need to be confident and say, you know what, I can do right spiritual practice. I can say, God, I've forgotten what reality is like, son of a gun. Can you help me out, please? I really need to be reminded. Do you have a way to remind me? And of course, the Holy Spirit, the grace of God has the way to remind us. The vision of oneness is how we're reminded. But within that vision, that goal of vision of oneness, there is a path. There is a path that moves us in that direction, okay? You just don't abruptly get the vision of oneness. No, it doesn't work that way. It takes a while. It takes a lot of adjustment. do, you're starting to realize, oh my gosh, I'm waking, I'm coming out of my coma, I'm coming out of my coma. And that's a little bit frightening, you know, so we don't want to do it too fast. I don't want to do it too fast. And that's totally understood. All the saints of God understand that. It's a gentle, gradual awakening. But the important thing is to get going in the right direction. All we're looking for right now is to get going in the right direction. That's it. And, of course, avoid going in the wrong direction. That's how you do it. You go in the right direction. That's the only way to avoid. You go in the right direction. You avoid going in the wrong direction. You're in. You got it. You're saved. And once again, all right, let's talk about it. People think they're not capable. They're not capable of focusing each day, at least a little bit each day. But each day, certainly we can't. Can't we say at least once during the day, or maybe for a little while, 10 minutes or something? Hey, I can't remember reality. I have a continuity problem. I have a continuity problem. And then just use this very simple technique. I don't have a body problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a governance problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an economic problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a financial problem. I have a continuity problem. The continuity problem is the only problem that I have. But I have a vast continuity problem. I have a continuity problem. I mean, I can't remember what reality's like. I need to be reminded. I need to be reminded. See, I've forgotten. So I have a continuity problem. Easy to do every day. Easy, 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 easy. Anybody can do that. Simple, easy. I have a practice problem. I say, you start with that. I have a practice problem. No, sorry. I made a mistake. That's okay too. See, I don't have a practice problem. I have a continuity problem. What you say is, when you're having trouble, you say, why am I not practicing? Why am I having this practice problem? Why am I not practicing? I'm distracted by safety thoughts. Oh, okay. I don't have a safety problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a practice problem. I have a continuity problem. And you just do it like that. Really, really, really easy. And of course you're going to make some mistakes and flip-flop them like I just did. Absolutely. That's not a problem. You just catch it and you say, oh, okay. Because remember, it's all about correcting mistakes. It's all about remembrance, which is the correcting the mistake of forgetfulness. So, I know there's a lot of people out there who are too smart by half. A lot. That's the curse of the modern age. It used to be people realized they're not so smart and they would take good advice. Well, we've been hoodwinked into thinking that we're really super smart when we're really not. And we've outsmarted ourselves. Just so many people are that way. And they say, you know what? We can figure out, we'll get through this, we'll figure out a way. Again, let me emphasize to those who are outsmarting themselves, this game here has got different rules now. As again, extraterrestrials, and yes, Virginia, there are extraterrestrials. Even NASA has said there are extraterrestrials, okay? Even the Vatican has basically come out and said it, you know? Basically. they give homilies of what, you know, what if we announced, you know, in a couple months' time that there are such a thing as extraterrestrials, we've discovered, we've been contacted, and yes. How would you react to that? Would that affect your faith? They've literally given homilies like that. So the Vatican, NASA, many countries around the world have opened up their archives on the extraterrestrials and basically say, yeah, they're absolutely, they're extraterrestrials. So yes, there are, and yes, they're involved. And they're heavily, heavily, heavily involved on this planet. They have an agenda here, and they don't play by our rules at all. They don't play by our rules at all. Whatever alliances they've made, they'll break. Whatever promises they've made, they will break those promises. They are not to be trusted. They don't play by our rules at all. Okay? So, you know, everyone's thinking how smart they are. Have you thought about that? Have you thought about that? I've thought about that my entire life. I've known my whole life all about extraterrestrials and what they're doing here. And they don't play by our rules. They have an agenda, they have a blueprint, and they're going to do what they're going to do. So you're not going to be able to deal with the situation the way you think you can. You are not going to be able to. You have to deal with it with the trump card, which is called right spiritual practice. There isn't any other way. There isn't any other way. You're not going to have some leader stand up and say, folks, I know the way, and it has nothing to do with right spiritual practice. We're going to fix it. No, that's not going to happen. That is not going to happen. The ETs have seduced the world. Okay, it's not going to happen. And what's going to happen is there are those who are going to stand up and say, you need to do right spiritual practice. That's the trump card. That's what's going to happen. Those are the saints of God, the teachers of God, who will say, you need to do right spiritual practice, and that's going to save you. That'll help. That's the road that sidesteps the whole situation, for sure. So if you think you're like really smart, well, just realize that the smartest of us in the world know about this whole thing, and they know that right spiritual practice is the only way to sidestep it. So get even smarter. Get even smarter. Nobody's saying you're not smart, really smart. Get even smarter. Well, isn't that what smart people do? They get smarter? That's exactly what they do. What do dumb people do? Dumb people insist that they're already smart enough. Don't be a dumb person. Be a smart person. Say, I'm really smart, and I know what my limitations are. I know that I need to get smarter, and I want to get smarter. I love getting smarter. So let me get smarter. Then you know, you're just proving how smart you are. That's all. So these times will prove who's really smart. Okay, who's really smart? It's like Santa Claus. Who's been naughty and who's been nice? You know, but it's really who's smart and who's not. Say, I want to get smarter. I want to play the trump card. Time to play the trump card here, folks. It's going to be time to play the trump card. And the trump card is right spiritual practice, for sure. Which is simply to say, what? God, I can't remember what reality's like. Would you please remind me? That's it. Honesty is the best policy. Honesty is the way. The path of remembrance. The way to sidestep is to be honest and just say, you know what? I've been super distracted. God, just so distracted. I can't remember what my home's like. It's been like I've been in a dream. It's like I fell into some deep dream. I'm so distracted. I can't remember. I've forgotten. And God says, absolutely. That's absolutely correct statement. You've forgotten. So now there is a way of remembrance. I have fashioned a path of remembrance for you, and it's there waiting for you. And that's all you have to do is just be honest and say, I need some help to remember. That's it. Now we've been trained in this false smartness, thinking I can figure out. I can remember what reality's like on my own. I can remember. I can figure it out. I can calculate it. Give me the computer. You know, give me the computer. I'm gonna Google reality and remember what it's like. You know, we've been outsmarted. I'm gonna look at my smartphone. I got some app there that's gonna tell me what reality's like. Been outsmarted. We've outsmarted ourselves. That's foolishness. That's stupidity. That's why I say the dumb phones, because people have invested too much faith in all that stuff. Too much faith in the internet, too much faith in the smartphones, the technology, etc. Thinking, I talk to young people, they say, you know, all the information we need is on the internet. What a joke that is. I have found in investigating the internet since it started that it is an incredibly arid desert of misinformation and lack of information, actually. It is very tepid at best. It is very cursory at best. It is very weak information at best. At best. Very poor source of information. And certainly, you cannot remember God from words and information like that. No, that's not the path of remembrance. So, right spiritual practice is honesty and saying, God, can you help me remember? Not I'm going to remember. Oh, I can't remember, so I'm going to remember. Can I get help in remembrance? I need help because I'm completely disoriented and have no idea where to look. My values are completely messed up. I have a vast, huge, intense continuity problem. I can't remember. And then once you admit that, then you start gradually remembering. God starts showing you that, you know, the path opens up for you. That's exactly what happens. I can absolutely testify to that. So it's going to be a very interesting month, to say the least. To say the very least. Pretty amazing month is coming up. Very amazing. The most amazing month, probably, that any of us have ever experienced. And for me, it has something to do with just being able to keep my confidence that I know right spiritual practice and can help others, you know, point out to them. And just trust that. Just trust it. Because that enables you to be in the presence of the saints of God, which is necessary right now. It's necessary for those who can to be in the presence of the saints of God now. It's absolutely necessary so that they feel confident enough to help others. And you can't say, oh, I'm unworthy, I'm undone. No, how could we be unworthy? No way. You put the effort in, you're worthy. Well, and right spiritual practice is very simple. Now, it can be, you can throw, there's a lot of variations. Of course, there's a lot of variety and variations that come once you get very good at it. Just like a piano, you can, you know, some piano players are incredibly good, but they started out just basic chords, just basic notes and chords. That's it. Started out the same way. Everybody starts out the same way. And they're still just hitting, you know, basic stuff, but they just learn how to break it up and get, you know, very, very beautiful at it. But sometimes the best piano playing is actually very simple. What's that piano player? Floyd Kramer, slip key playing. You know, a lot of people think that's just fabulous. Back in the 50s, you know, Patsy Cline, he played on Patsy Cline, he played on a lot of country western music that was beautiful, like The Last Dance and stuff like that. Just simple, slow, beautiful, simple, you know, but it just has like soul to it. It's got beauty to it. So really, right spiritual practice can be very simple, and like, you know, this moment as it is now. This moment as it is now. It's like slip key piano playing. You see some other piano players, you know, just really jazzy and blah, 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 all this stuff. But that simpler stuff, it's just like, you feel like, you know, it's just like something powerful, traction there. So this moment, as it is optimal. Very simple stuff. But you know, you're just right there with what you're saying. You're not trying to say anything else. You're 100% this moment, as it is optimal. This moment, as it is resolved. This moment, as it is resolved. Meaning, it is pure spaciousness. And so if you're just there for it, that's all that counts. That's all that counts. You don't need all the sophisticated stuff. It's just playing like last dance, very, you know, slow, beautiful slip key style. You're just there for every note, right? You're there for every note. There's the note. You say, ah, perfect. The note's right there. Just like that. The location of this moment doesn't matter. This moment as it is resolved. This moment as it is resolved. So, now is now. Spaciousness is spaciousness. Now is now. This is this. This is this. This is this. This is this. Super simple, right? Anybody can say that. It's a matter of just like listening attentively into music. You're right there with it. Your mind's like drifting off, and you're, you know, no, you're now. Is now. Now is now. Now is now. Truth is true. Truth is true. Truth is true. Truth is true. Just that. Truth is true. If you're really in tune, you just hit one note on the piano. You, dum, you know, it's like, ta. It's just like, that's it. That's all I need to hear. So it's not difficult if you start out with the honesty. God, I have a continuity problem. I can't remember what reality's like. Can you please remind me? Then from there on, you're good. You're good to go. You're good to go. Forget about all that complex esoteric stuff. No. I have a continuity problem. God, I have a continuity problem. I can't remember what reality's like. Would you please remind me? That is the safe way. Don't try to show off how smart you are by trying to do, you know, something really sophisticated and, you know, real flowery. Just playing, you know, just stay right in the simple groove of it. And that's where the traction is. Interesting stuff's going on in the world. You may notice some really interesting stuff going on in your life right now. Pay attention to it. Pay attention to it. We're getting all sorts of indications right now. As I've always said, when the trouble comes, it's going to come extremely fast. Extremely, way faster than anybody expects. It's like in a blink of an eye. The trouble is going to come like in a blink of an eye. Won't even see it coming. So, you'd better have at least know, I can say, you know, God, I can't remember what reality's like. Could you please remind me? I have a continuity problem. Just say, I have a continuity problem. That's it. You're saved just like that. It's that simple. And, you know, you don't have to get tricky about it. It just in your heart, you can say, okay, I'm going to remember reality. And you realize, I can't do it. I don't know how to, I can't do it. And you say, oh my gosh, I got a continuity problem. Can't remember what reality's like. God, would you please help me? I need help. I need help. I need help. Boom. You're safe. So that's where it's at. That's where it's at. That's where we have to focus on right now. Not on, you know, all the nuts and bolts of what's going to happen, what's coming, et cetera, et cetera. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. And just, you know, let it happen. Let it, whatever happens, let it happen. It doesn't matter, right? Because you're saying, I don't have a global problem. I have a continuity problem. God, I can't remember reality. Would you please help me? And then you're under the guide. You're under the protection of the grace of God at that point. You're under the protection of the grace of God at that point. Gentle protection, okay? Gentle protection, you know, absolutely. So for me, I'll probably have to be in the presence of you know, some of the saints of God. Have to, I that's a challenge for me to adapt to that at some point, for sure. Can't be intimidated by it. You know, I've got to keep my confidence. Say, you know, I do know how to practice. I do know right practice. Now is now. Truth is true. Truth is true. This moment is this moment. This moment is this moment. This moment is this moment. Because that's all there is to know. That is the truth. it's not something else. Reality is not something other than what it is. This moment is this moment. And that's all you need to know to be in the presence of the saints of God, because that's all they know. They know the truth is true. That's it. Nothing more than that. So to be in their presence, you have to be, you know, accept that also, yeah, that's all you need to know. So you're not panicking and saying, okay, what do I need to know? I need to know. No, there's nothing you need to know except truth is true. This moment is this moment. So it's really confidence and simplicity puts you in the presence of the saints of God. Familiarity with simplicity. Comfort zone. Your comfort zone is there. So most people, of course, their comfort zone isn't there yet. But you start out by saying, I have a continuity problem. That's how you start. You sit down at the piano and you sat down. Okay, now you know, hit a note. You hit one note. You say, okay, I've started playing the piano. That's how I started. I hit one note. Ding. Oh, that's nice. I hit another one. Ding, 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 ding. Okay. And then, what do? You hit a chord. Chung. Oh, that's nice. That sounds better. Some other chords, this one, okay, and then before you know it, you're playing. Just like that. I was a very good piano player in a previous life, and in this life, I took up piano again, and I was a super fast learner and just playing just amazing. But I wanted to do something, you know, I said, I got to do something way better than I did before. And it was too difficult. It was too much because it was just like trying to play a storm or something. You just there's some limits to the instrument. So I really burned out on it. But I know I was just like super confident. I just sit down. Okay. No, there's a note. There's a chord. Okay. Let me play a song now. Okay. I can play a song. Okay. Hey, let me play another song. And before you know it, learned like 50 songs. And then, you know, just it goes easy. If you have the confidence. If you don't have the confidence, it goes more slowly for sure. So you got to realize that there are those who have already have the confidence. Sometimes you see some spiritual people in this world, those who seem like they really get it, and they like fast, they just like, wow, how do they do that? Previous lives, for sure, is how they did it. You know, people looked at my piano playing this life and says, my gosh, he's so gifted musically. I mean, so confident, even overconfident, really. I was overconfident on the piano. I said, I can play anything. That's another thing. I would compose, you know, musical pieces on the piano, just boom, like that. And they're a little bit ragged, you know, because I was trying to find something fantastic. And people say, what? Wow, where's this? What's this coming from? Is some kind of musical genius or something? No. Because that previous life, that's how I already was that way, very familiar with the whole thing. So, of course, people come in here and they're able to do right spiritual practice, you know, to a tremendous effectively extent. Previous experience. Don't be intimidated by that. At some point, they all started out by just being honest with God. At some point, that's where they started. They all start in the exact same place. I looked at those great saints of God. I said, wow, how in the world can they be like that? Well, I'll tell you how. Right effort, right spiritual practice every single day. Decade after decade, however long, you know, they just keep doing it and doing it, doing it, doing it, doing it, doing it. And they get, you know, that's how they get there. Someone walks across country and say, how did you do that? Or walk around the whole world. Some people like walk around the whole planet or something. Or however much you can do that. And they finish, they say, how in the world did you do that? And they say, well, one step at a time. One step at a time is how they did it. And what's the first step? I can't remember what reality's like. I have a continuity problem. That's my real problem. Because if I didn't have that, I'd wake up to reality instantly. 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 Disappearance of the universe, you know. Wake up instantly. But I'm too afraid to do that, so I need help, God. I really need help. That's it. Very simple. So this is the time. I've definitely been tipped off that this is the time we've finally been waiting for. We're in it now. It's big time. So keep it simple. Absolutely keep it simple. Don't get outraged. This is the thing that what I found is that the world will try to outrage you now, to trick you into outrage. It's definitely happening. And you have to just say, I don't have an outrage problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an anger problem, I have a continuity problem. I don't have an upset problem, I have a continuity problem. I can't remember reality, that's my problem. It's not anger, anger's not my problem. I can't remember reality, that's my problem. So God, would you please help me? You have to do it, because they're starting to antagonize now. Purposefully, very, very deviously and purposely trying to antagonize you. Trying to antagonize you. And you just have to turn the other cheek. Turn the other cheek and say, I don't have an irritation problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an anger problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a fury problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have an outrage problem. I have a continuity problem. It's the only problem that I have. That's only the solution to a continuity problem is the only value there is for me. And the solution is the vision of oneness. The vision of oneness is the remedy for the continuity problem. It is the ultimate remedy. That's the goal, the vision of oneness. And so the other stuff has no value, no value whatsoever, none. Turn the other cheek at this time for sure. I can tell you for sure I've been struggling with this, being intentionally antagonized. And it's been a struggle, for sure. So that's what's up. That's what's up right now. That's what's going on. The ego will try to hit you with all sorts of inner thoughts too and stuff that is trying to antagonize you, mock you, etc. To say I don't have a world problem. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a distraction problem. I don't have a distraction problem. I have a continuity problem. You just have to stick with it. Stick with your honesty. Just go back to being honest and refuse to take the bait that they're trying to hook you with, okay? So, tomorrow I don't know what's going to happen. But I do know that we'll carry the Trump card into tomorrow, and that Trump card will trump. Whatever happens tomorrow, it will trump it. I have a continuity problem. I don't have a tomorrow problem. I have a continuity problem. Very great. That's it.